Canadian's Barrett injury to win the slalom, but he's injured again, a broken leg, can't go. What about the rest of the team?
Well, the slalom, I'd say a few years ago, is more of a tactician's race. Now it's basically turned into a drag race. You go as hard as you can for two runs. You got to get two runs in the bag. Remember this, the skiers that keep everything going down the hill, Karen, are the ones that are going to be successful. The team has nothing to lose. They've already got three races in the bag. It's go time.
It's the final event of Alpine. It's the slalom. Let's send it up to the top of the hill. Run one of the women's standing division. Here is Lauren Wollstonecroft of Victoria, native of Calgary. She has a gold and a silver in her pocket already at these games.
Lauren's got to get the skis going down the hill today, Karen. She's got to be aggressive and she's got to start the turn early. You notice that Lauren does not like to bash into many poles. She prefers to keep a clean edge and try to get that ski to accelerate more. She feels that's more beneficial for her style. Looking good here, working her way through the flush. You can tell she's looking 2 to 3 gates ahead at the split.
Now. Skis on two prosthetic legs, also with a prosthetic arm. That's why she has just the one pole.
And she's trying to be as clean as possible on this final pitch. If you notice right here, she's going to make a really strong drive to the finish. There she goes. Some real good skiing in this first run by Lauren Karen.
And that moves Lauren Wollstonecroft into first place for the time being, setting herself up for maybe her third medal of these games. Here's American superstar Allison Jones. She is in third place after the first run, but looking to do some damage here.
Well, this is her event, Karen. She really wants to make a statement here. She's been kind of playing second fiddle to Lauren all week at these games, and now it's time for Jonesy to really show the world what she's got. She's so aggressive. She's shinning each gate with her lower body, keeping the shoulders super square, and you can see the snap and the energy coming off that ski.
Jones skiing straight through those gates, a very different style than what we saw with Lauren Wollstonecroft, but obviously skiing on one leg.
Well, as long as she's powering through the great gate, Karen, there's no problem with that. It's when you try to hit the gate, you got to power through it, and Allison did a wonderful job.
What a great run by Allison Jones, and you can see her time there. Now with a 3.5 second advantage, Allison Jones moves into first place for the time being. Great crowds at Sestriere Borgata, over 4,000 in the stands every day. And here is Lauren Wollstonecroft, run number two. She finished her first run sitting in second place.
She's got to move up here, Karen. She's got to make some moves. She's got to make sure that she knows where she's going and that she's got the shoulders square and the ski accelerating. She's doing a wonderful job so far, working the flushes. I really like the way she's looking ahead on the course. She's got everything going for her with the shoulders and the upper body. Nice work with the gates there, getting a few out of the way. Oh, Karen.
What happened, Stacy?
Could be a mistaken inspection, could be a little bit of glitch in the system or a brain cramp. Very uncharacteristic, but you know, this is ski racing, stuff does happen.
Just missed the gate completely, maybe looking a little bit too far ahead. Lauren Wollstonecroft is out of the race. Over now to the women's sit ski classification. Here's Kimberly Joyness of Edmonton. She crashed in the GS, she crashed in the downhill, but she did win bronze in the Super G. This woman has a ton of talent.
Let's just see if she can make that talent work for her today in the slalom. As I said earlier, Karen, she's got to get the sit ski going down the hill. The more time she spends across the hill, like you just saw there, the more time she's wasting. Slalom is the type of sport and the type of event where you got to get it going down the hill and work that momentum with the fall line. Fighting the fall line and going against the fall line is just not going to work in this event, especially in a sit ski.
Well, she is a pioneer, Canada's first and only female sit skier. Suffered a spinal cord injury in a snowboarding accident in 2001.
I think she's finding the transition into ski racing sometimes difficult. There's so much focus and so much training required. She's doing a wonderful job with her natural talent, but you see right there, she's just not focused on making that turn above the gate. She waited too long, made a late turn, and pays for it by dumping it over on its side.
Similar to what happened in the giant slalom, just dumped and got herself back up. She's going to finish the run, but she really has no chance of getting up on the podium now.
We call that skiing out in the weeds, Karen. Going for a Sunday cruise almost.
So Kimberly Joyness will leave the Paralympics with one bronze medal. A great first-time effort for this first-time Paralympian. Here's Monty Meyer of the U.S. He is a veteran of this team, around since before even you started, Stacy. And he was 16th after the first run. Just had a terrible run looking to make amends here.
Well, you know Monty's going to have a good talk with himself in between runs. Him and the coaches will go over a few things, and they're going to remind Monty who he is and why he's here and what he's supposed to do. And it's showing in this run. Very aggressive. Shoulders are square. He's letting his one leg hit the gate as much as possible. Monty's padded all the way up to the top, and it pays off.
Nice run for Monty Meyer. That will be the fastest run of the day, and he will pull himself up from 16th position all the way to 8th.
Good job by the veteran, Karen.
Here's Jeffrey Penner of Kitchener, Ontario, 44 years old. He is a two-time Paralympian because he played in the 1988 Paralympics on Canada's wheelchair basketball team.
He goes down.
This is a whole new experience for him, and as you see right there, the inexperienced bug just bit him. It's slalom, it's technical, it's a bit of a go or blow type thing, and you saw him blow right there. Jeff's going to take a lot away from these Paralympics, and he knows what he has to do to make it happen in 4 years.
Well, he's not the only one crashing out today. We've seen many skiers have problems on this course. Here's Brad Lenny of Whistler, BC, 33 years old. He was 32nd in the first run.
I think both Kimberly and Jeff can learn a lot from what
Brad's also a sixth skier.
Brad's doing in the slalom. You see him take the gate out when he can. When he can't, he avoids it. But the main thing, Karen, is Brad is very good at getting that sit ski to go down the hill. He's making clean arcs. He's not out in the weeds. He's not on a Sunday cruise. He is trying to drive that sit ski down the fall line. And it's paying off on this final pitch. You see him making nice clean turns. The rest of the technique, the rest of the small things that he needs to get on the podium will come in time. But he's got an excellent base to work from.
He's not going to win a medal, but he is going to move up in the standings from 32nd to 25th. Nice second run for Brad Lenny of Whistler. Here's a look at how the other Canadians did today. Scott Patterson, 31st. Hinton, Alberta, finishes the 10K in 7th place. Jimmy Pelche, 29th place in the men's sit-ski 15K. When you talk about how the Canadians did in the mountain events, you have to start with the McKeever brothers. Two gold, a silver, and a bronze. Stacy leading a much improved Nordic team.
Well, the Nordic team doubled their output from Salt Lake. Colette Burgoyne back where she belongs on the podium. Two nice bronze medals, really a class of the field out here. Shauna Marie White, frustration, disappointment, that's the only way to sum it up. With the boys, JT Boilly, a nice dress rehearsal for 2010. And with Jimmy Pelche, he's seen what it's all about, Karen. Now it's up to him. Where's he going to go from here?
6 medals for the Nordic team, 5 for the Alpine team. Final evaluation of the Alpiners.
Well, the Alpine team had its ups and downs. Our World Cup champion led the way, Lauren Wollstonecroft. She, too, was on a bit of a roller coaster. Disappointment in the DH, a little controversy in the GS. But hey, a multi-medal performance, a silver and a gold out of her. Chris Williamson was well on his way to a multi-medal performance here when the injury bug struck him yet again, halting his games at the GS. With our sick girl, Kimberly Joyness, you know she's got all the natural talent in the world. She's got to focus on what the task is and really bear down and focus on 2010 and being on that top step. For the whole rest of the group, it's time to answer the call of the bell. They got to start training the way they feel on race day and racing the way they feel in training. Hopefully they can get it done for 2010.
Well, a gold medal to you, Stacy. First time on the other side of the camera. It's been great working with you.
Thank you, Karen.
Tara, back to you.
Thanks, Karen. And-